And to begin the most daring of countdowns, from England, live in the Countdown Studio, the human lead with the song that started it for them in Australia, Love Action. Special guests, the Human League, and they'll be back as soon as we check out the big ones across the nation. The J. Geils Band debut nationally at 23 with Freeze Frame. Dudley and Cream are renowned. Those super cute English pop stars, Haircut 100, have bounced in at 29 with Love Plus One. There's quite a deal of controversy as they jump into the national chart first week at number 25. that's the Chartbusters for another week, and now it's over to Molly with Adrian and Joe for the human league.
Thank you very much, Peter. Well, Adrian, welcome to the show.
Hello, Molly.
And to Australia. And Joe.
How you do?
Well, it's a long way from Berlin.
It certainly is.
I've got to sort of ask you, sort of like, first of all, are you surprised about the success of Human League now? Not just in Australia, I mean in England and now in America.
No, I think we deserve it.
No, being modest.
Sorry.
Well, I mean, it's gone to number seven.
I'm completely surprised. We just hit number seven in America today.
With both the album and the single.
The album and the single, yeah. Which I never thought we'd sell to Americans.
Right. What was it made to? I mean, like, it's sort of like, it's easy to say, like, you make a record, right? Were you making it sort of like with the English market and European market and sort of the other markets perhaps sort of made by it or what?
Yeah, I think you have a level you aim at when you first start, which was number one in England.
Right.
And then after you've got that, you then go for something else, which is number one in America, I think.
I don't think it was a conscious attempt to plan it for anywhere special. I mean, it was just came out the way it did, I guess.
Now, you've described it in Berlin as a pop album, and that's sort of pretty rare with groups where they say it's a pop album. Do you still go along with that?
Yeah, most groups don't admit it.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what we want it to make, so we made one. Most groups, like, try and couch it in some other terms, try and get serious about it, whereas we just want it to make a pop album that people would sing along with, you know?
Only in it for the money, eh?
No, you're not. Now, listen, just before we get to wind up, you do all the visuals, pick up all the visuals.
Yes.
Where do you get them from? I mean, like, some people say this is from Vogue.
Oh, this?
Right.
Well, it is.
Right.
No, I'm holding slides and things. I've got my flat's just full of old magazines, and I can't get in bed. I have to dive into bed from the door, and I just take them all from old magazines and things, and then I interpret the songs in the set with the slides.
Listen, Walter's sort of really winding us up.
Oh, is he winding us up?
So we'll be back soon. I don't know if you're aware of Tommy Chewtone doing big business. Do you like Tommy Chewtone?
No.
You don't? Well, it's going to be a hit anyhow. Here it is. It's causing havoc with the telephone calls in America. 867-5309. Anyone out there with the same number? Well, then bad luck. 867-5309, Jenny, Tommy Chewtone. That was Joe Kennedy with the Mackie and Me from the film Starstruck, which is about a girl who wants to be a pop singer. That's the whole story of the film. Now, with you two, it's a different story because, I mean, like, Phil, apparently, this is how the story goes, saw you at a disco and asked you to join the group as sort of what, dancers or singers?
Backing singers and dancers.
Now, what happened when you went home and you said to your parents you were going to go away on a European tour? I've got to find this out.
Well, we didn't go home and say that at first. We went home and hid.
Yeah, and we made excuses up and
then. And then I said to my dad, and he said, what's the Human League, a religious cult? And I said, no, it's a pop group.
And my parents weren't going to let me go because they thought, like, the usual thing with pop groups, sex, drugs and rock and roll. Until they met Philip and Adrian.
Right. You invited them home, right?
Yeah, I asked them to come.
When did you two make up your own minds you wanted to join the group, though? That night?
Yes.
Yeah.
We were going to run away if they weren't going to let us go.
Oh, right. Now, listen, as far as the group is concerned, I've got to say it, I think Dare is a great album, as you already know I've said that, right? You must be very proud of it. But what next?
Well, we're going back into the studio when we get back from this tour in about June.
Right.
Because we're going to Japan and Iceland and Canada.
All right.
When we finished here.
Listen, I can hear my producer through those earphones of Walter, who's our floor manager, waving like that, saying, get him off. So I've got to go into the next one. You saw Grace Jones. Your opinion of Grace Jones?
Good for half an hour, extremely good for half an hour and then boring.
Right.
I think she's fabulous.
So do I. So here's Grace Jones with something she did a couple of weeks ago, Walking in the Rain, and this should be a hit, and radio play it, all right?
walking down the street, kicking cans, looking at the billboard. Oh, so rad. Summing up the people, checking out the race, doing what I'm doing, feeling out of place, walking, walking in the rain.